Since the 1900s, humankind's technological advancements excelled, and things we didn't even think were possible became part of daily life. Most futuristic predictions came to fruition, some didn't, especially those involving cars. We still have no flying cars or any other super efficient engines in practice. When it comes to vehicles, our options have remained almost unchanged for over 100 years. In 2021, 6.7 million new electric cars were registered. This is more of an increase in electric cars in the last 5 years put together. It is certain that the popularity of electric cars is growing, but it is still not as popular as it was once. If you wanted to buy a car in the early 1900s, you'd have three options. One, a car powered by gasoline, with an internal combustion engine that requires hand cranking to start, produces loud noises and dirty smoke. Two, a steam-powered car, working with a gas boiler. As long as you have enough water and time to spare for the 30 minutes it takes the engine to heat up. Three, or an electric car, easy to start, clean and silent to run. If you were living in the city or had access to electricity, electric cars were the best choice. Just like today, they boasted low running costs, lower tax, they're environmentally friendly, and they're cool. Everybody wants one. So where did it begin? Why did we disown them and then push them back into the spotlight again? The electric car started in 1828, almost 200 years ago from today, with a simple yet genius electric rotary motor and a model vehicle that Agnes Jedlik created. Despite being just a model, it was the first time an electric motor was being used to power a vehicle. The first full-sized electric vehicle came in 4 years later, around 1832, from a Scottish inventor, Robert Anderson. It was run by a non-rechargeable primary battery and referred to as a horseless carrier rather than a car. The next big leap came from French inventor Gaston Plante. He invented a rechargeable lead battery in 1859, and shortly after, these batteries were evaluated for use in automobiles, which began to appear around Europe. Regardless of these two inventions, some consider that the history of electric vehicles started around 1880, in France, with Trouvé's three-wheeled vehicle. The French watchmaker's model was based on a small electric motor developed by Siemens, which was installed on an English tricycle. A year after Trouvé, William Ireton and John Perry created another three-wheeled electric car with a rechargeable battery. The main difference of this car was its ability to control speed by switching between 10 cells of the battery. It was also equipped with lights, had a top speed of 9 miles per hour, and travelled a distance of up to 25 miles. Those successful developments pushed electric vehicles into the mainstream. Unlike the gas models, they were easy to drive and lacked pollutants. Many different electric vehicles of all shapes and sizes rolled out across the globe. In fact, by the end of the 19th century, nearly 40% of American cars were powered by electric. This is an enormous number compared with just 2% of vehicles on the road being electric today. So what happened to electric cars and their dwindling popularity? The biggest problem with the early electric cars, which still rings true, is the expensive and inefficient batteries. Some car companies built exchange stations where you could swap out dead batteries in an attempt to ease the problem. Many inventors had worked on getting batteries to store more energy, including Thomas Edison and Ferdinand Porsche, who started their business with an electric car in 1898, and later created the first hybrid car. But neither the exchange stations nor the efforts spent trying to improve the batteries were enough to make electric vehicles efficient, cheap, and suitable for long trips. Around the same time, other positive developments for gas-powered cars, such as low gas prices, electric starters, and quieter engines, made them more favourable. But the biggest hit to the electric cars came from Henry Ford's, the Ford Model T. Model T was the first mass-produced car. It was simple to operate, durable, and affordable. the initiation of mass-produced gas vehicles drove the prices down as much as half of an electric car's price. Most electric car manufacturers stopped around 1910, and by the 1920s, the electric automobile industry had effectively disappeared. Over the following years, cheap gasoline and continued improvements in gas engines created little need for alternative fuel. Electric vehicles were mostly used for low-speed, short-range urban transport and delivery jobs. Around the 1960s and 70s, increasing gas prices sparked a little interest in electric vehicles again, and some companies started experimenting with them, including NASA. The Lunar Rover helped raise the profile of electric vehicles, but somehow the interest faded away again until the 1990s. The race to thrive wasn't just apparent in the car industry. Global fossil fuel combustion and industrial processes have seen a dramatic rise since the birth of the Industrial Revolution. Towards the end of the 20th century, our carbon emissions reached their peak. This scary realization, combined with recent rising gas prices and new technologies, helped to boost the interest in electric vehicles one more time.
The electric car is here.
General Motors' EV1, Toyota's hybrid Prius, and Tesla's Roadster are the pioneers of this new era of electric vehicle. But batteries are still the biggest problem. The longest range you can travel today with one charge is 450 miles. Another issue is their effect on the environment. Electric cars produce zero emissions when running, but ironically, the electricity you use to charge your car still partly relies on fossil energy. Also, disposing of dead batteries is another major environmental problem, as only about half of the materials in an EV battery pack are recycled. Research and development on electric vehicles and other alternatives is still being pushed, but every alternative fuel has its own set of problems to deal with.